Hello everyone and welcome back to The Perfect French with Dylan. Today we keep going with the focus on conjugation and pronunciation, and we are going to see the verb avoir conjugated in the five tenses that you should absolutely know when you start learning French. So we are going to see the verb avoir conjugated présent, passé composé, imparfait, futur simple, and finally conditionnel. If you want to go from one to the other, please do. The timings are going to be in the description box. After we see every conjugation, we are going to focus on the pronunciation. You should absolutely know avoir from the beginning. It's a very important verb. We use it all the time. And it's also an auxiliary for compound tenses. Okay? We are going to see it especially with passé composé. So let's look at the présent. So first, we are going to review very quickly the pronoun subject. So we have je, technically it's not je because avoir starts with a voyelle. So je, tu, il, elle, on, nous, vous, il, elle. So don't forget that il, elle pluriel are pronounced exactly the same as il, elle because we don't pronounce the S. So if we add the conjugation, we have j'ai, tu as, il a, elle a, on a, nous avons, vous avez, ils ont, elles ont. So here, for tu as, il a, elle a, on a, the pronunciation is the same. It's a. The AS from tu is not pronounced as, it's not pronounced like that. We don't pronounce the S at the end, so it still makes the same sound as the other one. A. And then we have on, which has a link. On, na, na. I'm going to underline all the links during this lesson. On, na. Then we have nous avons. We don't pronounce the S at the end of avons. And then we have a link as well. Nous avons. Vous avez, link as well, and a Z make the sound E. And finally, ils ont, elles ont, have the same pronunciation. For both of them, we don't pronounce the T, and then for both of them, we have a link. Ils ont, elles ont. Now, the passé composé. This one is a tiny bit more complicated than the others, because it's going to be the verb avoir conjugated present tense that we just saw, plus the participe passé of avoir, which is EU, pronounced U, U. So we know the pronoun subject, we know the verb avoir conjugated present tense, we just saw it, and then we just need to add everywhere the participe passé U. So we have j'ai eu, tu as eu, il a eu, elle a eu, on a eu, nous avons eu, vous avez eu, ils ont eu, elles ont eu. So for the pronunciation, it's almost the exact same way as the present tense that we just saw before. The only difference here is that I added the AI from G is pronounced E, like E accent aigu. In some areas, it can be also pronounced as G, but technically AI together, only AI, make the sound E. It only makes the sound E when it's followed by a S, T, ENT, etc. So we have that. Then we have the four other ones that pronounce exactly the same. Tu as eu, il a eu, elle a eu, on a eu. The S from A isn't pronounced. Then we have a link between on, a, on, a. Then we have nous avons eu. The S at avons is not pronounced. And then we have a link between nous and avons. Nous avons. Vous avez eu. Same thing, we have a link between vous and avez. Vous avez. And then we have the two last ones. Ils ont eu. Elles ont eu. The T are not pronounced, and then we have a link between each. So, ils ont eu, elles ont eu. Third tense for today is the imparfait. So we know the pronoun subject. Then we are going to add the radical. The radical is the part of the verb that is not going to change. And then we are going to add the ending to the radical. So the radical for avoir conjugated in the imparfait is avait. Avait. So we are going to add that everywhere. And then we are going to add the endings. The endings for imparfait are AIS, AIS, AIT, 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 IONS, IOZ, AIENT, AIENT. You remember I just told you that AI followed by SOT, OENT is pronounced E, like E accent grave, E. So, j'avais, tu avais, il avait, elle avait, on avait, nous avions, vous aviez, ils avaient, elles avaient. If we look at the pronunciation here, we have seven same pronunciation. We have avait, the five first, and then the two last have the same pronunciation, avait. Because we don't pronounce anything after AI, so we don't pronounce the S, we don't pronounce the T, and then we don't pronounce ENT. Never. So the pronunciation is exactly the same. We do have a slight difference with the links. So we have on avait, ils avaient, elles avaient. Then we have nous avions, vous aviez. The S at avion isn't pronounced. And then we have the links, so nous avions, vous aviez. That's it for the imparfait. Now let's see the futur simple. So we know the pronoun subject once again. The radical for this one, so the part that is not going to change, is AUR. Or. Or. AU is pronounced like a soft O. Or. Or. Okay? So we're going to add this one everywhere. Then we have the ending for the futur simple, which are AI, AS, AAA, ONS, EZ, ONT, ONT. So we have j'aurai, tu auras, il aura, elle aura, on aura, nous aurons, vous aurez, ils auront, elles auront. So the futur simple is probably my favorite conjugation to look on the side of the pronunciation, because we have very interesting combination here, I would say. So j'aurai and vous aurez are pronounced exactly the same. So because AI at the end make the sound E, and then EZ at the end make the sound E as well. So j'aurai, vous aurez. The only difference here is the link, vous aurez. Then we have the regular A, so tu auras, il aura, elle aura, on aura. Pronounced exactly the same since we don't pronounce the S at aura with the tu. And then we have the link at on aura. And then the last group for pronunciation is auront, auront. So here, auront, O-N-S, nous aurons. And ils auront, elles auront, pronounced exactly the same. So we don't pronounce the S, we don't pronounce the T, and then we have the links. Nous aurons, ils auront, elles auront. The last tense we are going to see today is the conditionnel. So when you say would in English, we have a specific conjugation for that. If you want to know more about would, should, could, I will put the videos in the description box, as well as for the futur simple, passé composé, imparfait. Everything is going to be in the description box. So for this one, of course, we know the pronoun subject. Then the radical is the exact same one as the one we use for the futur simple. A-U-R pronounced or, or. Then we are going to have the ending, which are the exact same one as the imparfait. So we have A-I-S, A-I-S, A-I-T, 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 I-O-N-S, I-O-Z, A-I-O-N-T, A-I-O-N-T. So if we read the whole thing, we have j'aurais, tu aurais, il aurait, elle aurait, on aurait, nous aurions, vous auriez, ils auraient, elles auraient. Now I'm sure you should be able to recognize the pronunciation that are similar. So we have the five first one and the two last one, exactly like the imparfait, have the exact same pronunciation. So we have aurait, 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 aurait. Because we don't pronounce the S, we don't pronounce the T at the end, and then we don't pronounce the E and T. So the pronunciation is exactly the same. Beside the links, which are on aurait, ils auraient, elles auraient. Then the two last ones are nous aurions, vous auriez. So aurions, we don't pronounce the S. And then we have the link, nous aurions, vous auriez. That's it for the verb avoir. Don't forget to get your free PDF or your free ebook. It's up to you. If you have a question, please leave it in the comment section. I will do my best to help you. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like this video. It really helped me. And I will see you soon for another lesson.